Hi! Oh, this is so fucking weird! What the hell? Oh, this is so weird. Oh, this is so fucking weird. Hi! 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 One in chat. If you up right now, chilling. Yo. Why am I going to look so different? Dude, you don't chat. You know how happy I am seeing names in chat? I was scared I'd go live, there'd be like five of you guys. And like three of them would be like bot accounts. I'm just really glad there are real accounts in my chat. Guys, I think we've hit 10 subs. I think we've hit 10 subs as well. I had 6 before I went live. I think we've hit 10. This is big. Okay. Hold on. Where are we at? Coding Fade, thank you for the sub. Lachlan, thank you for the sub. Sarah Pog, thank you for the sub. I don't know her name. Chillax, thank you for the sub. And Sarah Pog, thank you again. Hi, everyone. Hi. This is really weird. I haven't done this in a really long time. How are we all doing? Where do I start? Okay. Chat. Devin, thank you for the 14 months. Chat, this is what happened. Alright. Scott, Johnny. Thank you, guys. Thank you. Basically, this is what happens. I went to America in the summer. And I was like, fuck it. Ben, thank you for the 20 months. I was like, I went to America in the summer. I was like, fuck it. You know what? It was nice not streaming for 3 weeks. Maybe I'll like chill a bit. Maybe I'll chill on the streaming when I get back. And then I just was like, wow, I'm not fucking miserable. I am not incredibly miserable. And I was. Because I was like, I killed Chad, I killed too hard. I killed past the point of no return. But no, it was the fact, right, even 19 months, I have been streaming like most days. I think that's fair, like, consistently, since I was, like, 14, and I'm like, you know what, I'm gonna try being a normal 17-year-old boy, for a while, and it was awesome, I was awesome, apart from, okay, this is what happened. I was never planning on, like, permanently quitting. I always said it was a break. And you fuckers didn't believe me. None of you fuckers. I was like, I'm coming back streaming. Like, yeah, sure you are, Harry. Yeah, I hope you. Fuck off. I'm sick and tired of every fucking one of you. Alright? No. I'm joking. Matter, thank you for the 20 months. I believe you, babe. Thanks, Scott. None of you guys believe me. Yeah, Harry, you're coming back. Look at me now. I need to open a window, dude. I'm so hot in here. But, Chad, I have a whole presentation of what's been going on. Don't worry. There's been lots of lore. Max! Maxi G's! Yippee! 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 Hi, Max, thank you for the raid. Oh my god. Alright. Max Raiders. You might not know me. I am Max's friend. I leech off him a bit. I haven't streamed for like 6 months. I'm back now. This is my big, huge comeback stream because I'm just that popular. Yeah, basically, I didn't stream, and then I was like, okay, well, my bank account is in a steady decline, and it's going to get to a point where I can't afford a meal deal. So I'm like, fuck it. I got a job, chat, at Argos. I'm going to move this back. I got a job at Argos. All right. And then I realized, chat, you thought streaming made me miserable? You've never seen me work a shift at Argos. Chat, you've never seen me work a shift at Argos. Wow, that's a different type of miserable. Alright, that's crazy, man. It's me, it's literally me sitting there going, hey, what's your collection code? Oh, you want me to refund your washing machine? Kill yourself, man. No, fuck. I haven't streamed in a while. I forgot to. Don't kill yourself. Anything I say, purely. I forgot myself. In a video game. Hi, Kayak. No, chat. Hansen chat for Argos workers. No. So I was like, okay. And then I'm like, oh, I miss streaming. Because I also got incredibly fucking depressed. Like, you'll catch up. This will be in the catch up, guys. Don't worry. I will mention this. There's a lot. There's a lot of lore you guys missed out on of me becoming a normal person. Which, I mean, we can jump into it. This is pre-recorded. Yeah, it's like a German stream. This is, okay. Max! Yo! No. Anyway. Average Harry Wrapped. I need some background music. Average Harry Wrapped by Average Harry. Why is Misgiv a VIP in this chat? Okay. No, spoilers. Okay, let me un-VIP Misgiv. Listen, chat. I haven't streamed since before, like, every single member of OTK became a bad person. Alright, that chat, there's probably gonna be some shit I need to change, alright? Okay. Since I've stopped streaming, the UK has been through, like, 3 different prime ministers. Why is Carson a VIP? He's not, is he? It's not, oh, it's when you came around my house. You told me to do it. Hi, Stone Park. Anyway, chat. Average Harry Wrapped. Where have I been for the past 6 months? Well, August. This is where it all went downhill. This is where it all went downhill for you guys. So, August started. I found this really cool picture of a cat, which I wanted to include, because that's kind of how I felt. I was like, I'm taking a break from streaming! Yippee! And then, I was like, Axel was in the UK. Axel Ali, my Estonian friend. I love you, Axel. And he's down in Brighton, and he messages me, and he goes, Harry, come down to Brighton, man. Come down to Brighton. We can, like, grab dinner or something with Max. So I'm like, yeah, okay. So I message him. This dude's a fucking bum. It's like 1 p.m. And I'm just, like, walking around Brighton. This dude's responding to my text. And he goes, yeah, man, we're gonna grab, like, lunch with Ash. And I'm like, okay, hell yeah. And there's, like, this calf in, like, the lanes. And Ash is... I'd never, like, me and Ash were, like, mutuals on Twitter, but I'd never, like, probably spoken to before. This is Ash Caboose. You guys know him. And I'm like, okay, hell yeah. And when we're walking to the calf, I bump into Ash. And it's actually incredibly awkward. I think he thought I was a fan. Because I went, Ash! And, like, went in for the hug. And he was like, oh... He hugged me back, like, eventually, but he's like, oh, okay. And I'm like, it's Harry. He's like, Harry and Manx. And then he knew what was going on, but it was an awful interaction. So then it was like, we like, chilled there. And then, like, Tommy Innit just came and sat with us. And I was like, what is this? It was like a fucking, it felt like a Family Guy cutaway sketch. He came in, like, like when the celebrity cameos in, like, a fucking sitcom. And I just came and sat for 20 minutes and, like, went away. And I'm like, okay, that's cute. No way you're running ads? No way you're not sub to me. Max, I took your virginity and you won't give me £5 a month, prick. So, and then Ash is like, oh, yeah, we're doing a show tonight. I'm like, fuck off. If you were doing a show tonight, boy, I'd see all the people with blue hair on Twitter talking about it. I don't believe you guys. No, we're doing one under a fake name. And I'm like, oh, okay, never mind then. So he's like, yeah, you can just get on the guest list. And I'm like, I'll go on the damn guest list. I'll go on the damn guest list. So it's like, me and Max are on this guest list. And, like, it was cute. It was, like, their second, like, show. And it was, like, it was really cute. I still love Joy. And then, obviously, this link up where everyone was like, you're good. Stay safe, Mills. And I was like, it was like me, Max, James, Jack Manifold, Nep, and Bill. Bill! Everyone's like, Bill? I don't think you guys were chill anymore. Chat? I can't say it, but there's some cool shit happening, and you're gonna have to take my word on it. You gotta take my word on it. We'll get to that. So, and then, came down, like, the next day, and I was like, it was Quabby! Quabby! Quabby came over, linked up with him. I think I've had a bit bad, because I go, don't steal from small businesses. I took some shit from here, because they were trying to charge me £12 for an enamel pin. You ain't got CCTV, that shit's going in my pocket, I'll be so real. I'm not paying £12 for an enamel pin. I don't care who you are. I don't care who you are. And he's going in my pocket. And then I saw this TikTok, which it doesn't really have much to do with me. You stole that? Yeah, sorry. I saw this TikTok, but it was like when the Little Miss trend is big. And it's like Little Miss gave head to a boy on a school trip and a hand job at school under the stage in the same week. Chad, I've got to go to West Sussex. I know what, that shit sounds fucking awesome. Who wants to go on a trip to West Sussex? I'm trying to get a hand job under the stage. What the fuck? Don't question mark me like I'm the bad guy here. Okay. I think the focus on my camera's fucked. Oh, Jay, look at this cut on my hand. That's foreshadowing. That's foreshadowing for last night. At a school. Yeah, my bad. Anyway, and then, oh, this was an awful, Chad, this is when we went round to Scott's, and we all kind of slept round, Scott's, in a tent, and it was me, Scott, John A, and Quabby, and I was meant to be on, like, the same, like, And I was like, I was meant to be in, like, the same, like, mattress as John A. And then I didn't trust that man. I felt like his cock would slip out in his sleep. And I was really, really uncomfortable next to that. He also sleeps with his eyes open. Like, he is, like, completely, like, knocked out here. And there's a slit. Like, I can see it. And I'm like, you're weird. I'm not sleeping next to you, boy. So I like, spooned Quabby the whole night. But, like, in a friendly way. Angry. Stop question marking me. Alright. Chill. That was August. It was still summer. I wasn't going back to school yet, but then, bam! Oh. But then, bam! September hit! September hit! Right. September didn't flop. September, we go back to school. This photo here. Chat, this is like a 2 minute. This is like a 2 minute long video. I got incredibly fucking drunk. And I was just sitting there. And it was like this, that, I don't know, I was drinking at a friend's house. And, holy shit, the entrance. I was drinking at a friend's house, and they didn't have, like, LED lights. So I just put, like, a color-changing telly on. And I was I was in awe. I was actually in awe. And then, what happened? This, I watched Marcel the Shell with shoes on. The film, like, the mockumentary about the little shell. And that broke me. That broke me. But look. Chat is literally how fucking that fucks, dude. I'm sorry, that fucks. So I got that. Shout out Marcel. And then I had a bonding experience, chat. September, for like the 25 year anniversary or some shit. They were like, oh, we're re-releasing E.T. in IMAX. I'm like, I want to see E.T. in IMAX, sure. I go there. It's me and one other dude in the cinema. And we're like, in like, entering like the final act, and my phone starts buzzing like a motherfucker. It starts buzzing like a motherfucker. I'm like, what's going on? I check my phone. And it's, the Queen's died. Chad, the Queen's died. And Chad, this is kind of how the cinema was, it's like, it's like you enter here. No, you enter like here. And there's like the seats are all like here, right? And I was like smack bang in the middle. And like 3 rows forward and like to the right, there was one other person in the cinema. And I'm like, I've got to, I don't know why. I was like, I've got to tell this guy mid movie. So I like, I walked along, and then I, like, climbed over, like, 2 rows of seats. I was like, dude, he's like, you got really fucking scared. He's like, I'm like, dude, the Queen died. He's like, what? And I'm like, yeah. And he's like, oh, I'm sorry. I'm like, no, you don't apologize. I mean, you're just really, I don't know why I did it. But I insisted on being the one who broke the news. I was dead sober. I was like, yeah, man, the fucking Queen died. It's like, all right, man. It's like, okay. And then I came out, and it was like every single billboard had been changed to this. So I got a picture, because I'm like, this is big. This is like, they're never gonna show us again. So I'm like, I better get a picture of it. And then, but I disposal camera, no, because I went to the party yesterday, sorry, James, so I was like, I gotta, he came out, did he get Randa take that pic? Yeah, and I actually thought they were gonna take my phone at one point. Chat, this picture here, I got invited to, a party hosted by someone who goes to Brit School. I don't know what Brit School is, everyone like London. Brit School is like a performing arts school. It's like, they have like a bunch of alumni, like I think like RuPaul went there and like fucking like Adele. And it's like the school from like Victorious, right? So it's like maybe Tori Vega was there, possibly. I think RuPaul went to Brit School. And I got invited to one of their parties. I'm like, yeah, fuck it, I'll go. And, hi, Gabs. And I was like, yeah, I'll go, sure, man. And I've been sent the, RuPaul's American. RuPaul went to Brit School. I don't know, they had a fucking picture of him framed. Okay. He has some relation to it. This is, Chad, Max, I don't want to talk about it. Oh, wow. basically, I'm at this party, and they send me the address, and it's in Wimbledon, but it's in the nice part of Wimbledon. It's like where they play the tennis, and I'm like, what the fuck? So I get there. I actually don't know. I know like 3 people there, and latest I pulled me out in Atlanta. Okay, maybe it wasn't RuPaul. He's a famous drag person. So I'm like, okay, sure. I'm here, and I go, hey, do you guys have any drink? Like, because I brought my own drink, but like, is there like any communal drink? Because I'm like, I'll risk getting herpes if I can have a fun night. They're like, yeah, open the fridge. I'm like, what the fuck do you mean open the fridge? Chad, these motherfuckers were rich. There was like a big Samsung like fridge, which has like 2 doors. And I swear to God, I swung it open and it was head to toe filled entirely in like beer. Like any time. And Chad, I hate beer. But I was like, okay, this is the only time I've ever gotten beer drunk. So I'm like, okay, all right, yeah. Like, it was crazy. So I'm like, yeah, I might as well. So I just kind of, I'm necking them. So I don't really know enough people there. And I'm like, I'm just gonna, once I get enough alcohol in me, I genuinely take the piss. I chat with anyone about anything. But Brit school people are really hard to speak to because they all think they're fucking better than you. They come up to you, they go, so, what strand do you do? I'm like, what? They're like, yeah, what strand do you do? Are you music or like acting or theater? I'm like, I don't go to Brit school, man. And he goes, oh, so what do you do? I'm like, I go to school and I do like some like social media stuff on the side. That's what I say because they're always quite weird about it. And they're like, cool. Well, I'm like a ethical DJ focusing in like the prehistoric era. That's not fucking true. You're making you're putting a combination of words together. That's not a real fucking thing. I think they saw me walking and like the party went silent. You know like that scene in Get Out where he goes up the stairs and the entire party goes silent? They saw me like go into the bathroom and like, okay, now everyone just makes shit up. Everyone starts lying to him about what you do. And I'm like, okay, sure. And then they always like, they speed run it. They go, hi, what's your name? What strand are you doing? Oh, that's cool. Can I have a cigarette? I'm like, no, you can't. But basically, chat, I just kept going back to the fridge for beers. And I got beer drunk. And I'm sitting there. We all had to go inside at this point. We're all sitting in the living room. There's like 25 of us. And I'm like sitting there like this. And then I like check my phone. And I'm like, fuck, it's like 1 a.m. I need to get home. And I was so drunk. I didn't know a single, I looked around. All my friends had left. My friends are actually bad friends leaving me there. All my friends had fucking left. So I'm like, I'm sitting there. And I go, fuck, I need to get home. I need to get home now. And I'm like, I stand up. I just like run out the room. And I knocked over like 4 fucking drinks. And I was like, fuck, but I'm like, I'll never see these people again. And then I started running. I was like, I'll never see these people again. And I knocked off like 4 fucking beers. And I was like, dude, I'm like, sorry. And I think I like pretended my Uber had arrived. And I'm like, dude, I'm sorry. And I'm like, sorry, I'll never see these people again. Until the next month, my friend, who goes Brit school, said, we're doing a performance, Harry, won't you come along? I'm like, yeah, I'll come along. Oh, is my stream crashing? No, I was like, yeah, I'll come along. I love going to concerts. And then they kind of all went to the pub afterwards, and I'm there, and I'm talking to people. And this girl comes up to me and goes, I remember you. You were at my party. And I was like, yeah. Her name was like Jess. I'm like, yeah, Jess, right? She goes, yeah. You're the one who spilled all the drinks. No. No, that wasn't me. That was my twin. That was not me. And then, what's this? What's this? Chad, I rewatched The Florida Project. I cried like a bitch. Fucking love that movie. And then I saw ABBA. I saw ABBA, everyone. I saw ABBA Voyage. And it was really fun. It was really fun. I saw it with my friend Emily. Now, October. September, I think I streamed once. October is when I'm completely off it at this point. Bang. Bang. This is when I became normal. When I became normal. October. What happened in October? It started. Dream. Man. Do I become, like, non... I'm not problematic. I never claim to be problematic. Do I have to stay clean off of drama, though? No, dude. No, Dream's, like, actually a bad fucking person, actually. No, yeah, fuck Dream. That, he responded, he Facebooked, big ass chin. And I was like, I was firing off tweets. One of them banged. One of them got like 500k. Ked, thank you for the 5 months. Like, one of them fucking banged. And I'm firing them off like every like 20 minutes. This is crazy. I'd actually be so real. Chat, if I was faceless and I was showing my face and like Max tweeted, every let's all be kind. My brains would be on the ceiling. I'll go for a swing on my ceiling fan. Like, my tweets, I was shooting like Kobe. I was going fucking crazy on the tweets that night. It should have numbers. Is this the riddle one? It shit was crazy. What? It hit 300k. I don't know what happened. Yeah, you know they only offered me like 10 bucks? You know that. I'm like, I'm not doing that shit for 10 bucks. Fuck off. Primo, thank you for the 11 months. Chad, do you think I have 15 subs now? Yippee! Yippee! Thank you for the 25 subs. This is big. Everyone, please remember that your words matter. During Facebook, it was like ugly, and now I'm like, it's like, it was, I don't know, and everyone's like, it was like, don't body shame, because what if your friend who has the same features of him gets offended? If I've run out of big chin, I'd tell him. Like, he knows. Heather's weird, I think, for the tier one. Fuck off, Max. Fuck off. Because you're not even lying. Fuck off. And then what? What happened then? Oh, I went to a James Marriott gig. Did I get snuck in on this one? I think this is the one where I got snuck in. Maybe. Yeah. Yeah, Chad, I got snuck in as George Mimulus. They were like, yeah, dude, his name's George. And I was like, oh, hell yeah. And they were like, yeah, come in the back. And I was like, backstage of everyone. And I was like, I was looking around. I'm like, the net worth of this room is like fucking like 20 million. And like 80% of it was like Tommy in it. I'm like, dude, the net worth is crazy. And average Harry, what's average Harry here? It's like, who invited my man? What's going on? What is this? No, shout out James. I actually love that dude. And I was with Connie and Lav. Lav, Lav, Lav. And then, October, I get an email. You're invited to a BFI. British Film Institute early screening of Glass Onion, Knives Out. Yippee! It was awesome. Chad, it was terrifying though. I felt like a criminal the whole time. I felt like a fucking criminal. They were like, before I go in, there was three different people had to check my tickets. Then there was a woman who was like, put your phone away. Do not turn it on. If you're caught using any sort of device, you will be removed and the police will be called. Fuck off, will the police be called? 909, someone's on his phone in a cinema. Kill yourself. Nah, piss off, fuck off, man. That's bullshit. You're not calling the police for that. All right. But I'm like, I was nervy. I was a little bit nervy. So I'm like, okay. I sat there. They had to, instead of playing trailers, we had to watch like a gala, the opening night gala of like everyone being interviewed. This is so fucking boring. No, I'm joking. It was fun. I watched Glass Onion, and then I literally couldn't talk about it for 3 months till it came out like 2 weeks ago. Did everyone like it? I need to rewatch it. I thought it was really good, but it was really different to the first one. Like, really different. I thought it was really funny, though. And that was good. And also, Clint, you can't see it. There was a man there, and a man there, who sat there the entire time with, like, binoculars, like, infrared binoculars, seeing if I was, like, filming anything. Like, come on, man. Let's be FFR. Be fucking for real. Alright? Ugh. I can't believe she did that. I don't know. I thought it was fun. I love, don't awkward me. Don't fuck off, all of you. I thought Mars Fuzzy was bad, but it was still an enjoyable watch, I think. I think it was far from a bad film. And then what? Oh, I saw Upstart Crow, the play, and I nearly had to be removed because I wouldn't stop laughing. But no, like, jokes had been told yet. Basically, chat, do you guys know what Upstart Crow is? Because I didn't until my friend gave me tickets. It's like this show of, and it's like, he's like Shakespeare, but the guy who plays Shakespeare is the guy, it's David Mitchell, who plays Mark from Peep Show. And I love Peep Show. And if you, I fucking, Chad, do you guys know Peep Show? It's like this British TV show. And it's like all from the POV of other people. But he sounds very distinct. And when he walked out on stage, and I was in, like, the second row, I couldn't stop laughing. He was, like, doing a monologue, and I couldn't stop laughing because I could imagine, like, it was a peep show. He's like, what the fuck am I doing here? And I made myself laugh so much, they nearly had to remove me. At work, I had to come over and ask if I was okay, and I was so fucking embarrassed because I couldn't even talk. I'd convinced myself it was that funny. It was really embarrassing. And then this... This night here is when it all started going downhill. And I nearly had to go to hospital. So, it's Halloween week. I got a few parties lined up. And Johnny's birthday, Dickie didn't even turn up. John, don't take the piss. Relax. So, the night before, it was my friend Emily's mum's like birthday. So I went around to hers and I got absolutely pissed. It's the only time I've ever like thrown up from like drinking. Like I was wine drunk. It was bad, okay? And then, it was this night, where it was the same, it was Georgia, this girl called Georgia, very, very, very wealthy, private school girl, was like, oh, I'm having people around for Halloween. I'm like, yeah, I'll come around. And I was young lean. Could you tell? I was young lean, and Michael forgot to dress up. So I was like, yeah, we'll come. Bear in mind, I had gotten pissed literally like 24 hours beforehand. It's whatever. I go there. I get absolutely fucked. And you know what did it for me? Hi, Zen. It was Hennessy. I had Hennessy. I never drink Hennessy because I fucking hate Hennessy. I have Hennessy. Chad, I wake up the next morning. I'm like, I throw up. Because I'm like, okay, it was 2 days of extra drinking. Calm. And then I throw up again. And again. And now I've been sitting over the sink for 2 hours. And I'm not even throwing up anything in my stomach. I'm throwing up like bile. Like it's like bright yellow. So I'm like, okay, I'll just have something to drink. I'm really dehydrated. I have something to... Within 10 seconds. And then there's nothing coming up, but I'm still retching to the point where it hurt to breathe. I had to lay, you know, like that clip where like Peter Griffin like breaks his own neck and then he's like that on the ground. That's how I had to lay on my bed for it to be able to like not hurt when I breathe. Anything I drank or ate would come within 10 seconds to the point where all, and this went on for 3 days. Chad, I got alcohol poisoning. Worst experience of my life. Like actual, like worst experience of my life. It was me. I would like just come in and out of consciousness, go, and then like go shit. I was like, it's like that one TikTok audio. And I was like, and then I nearly had to go to hospital because on the third day, I still couldn't even drink anything. And I was like, luckily I got better. But it was like, I had to suck on ice. I had to suck on ice in order to get any like liquid in me. And it was like the worst experience ever. That wasn't fun, but 1 week later, I was back on it. I went as Austin Powers and Emily went as a fembot for a Halloween party. Because Chad, I'm the goat. Because I'm the goat at the end of the day. And that puts us into October. October was fun. I had alcohol poisoning. But, you know, I wasn't heavily depressed. And then November hit. Bang. Bang. Gallist. Hold on. Whoa, Gallist. Basically, what happened November? Remember the 5th of December. 5th of November, gunpowder treason and plot. Firework night. Bang. This is me at the US Embassy. I went on a school trip to the US Embassy. Probably worst school trip I've ever been on. I just want to make that clear. We had to listen to like 2 ex-House representatives. One was Democratic, one was Republican. And the Democratic one was like, yeah, man, like, I just think, you know, gay people, should exist and you should have an abortion. Dude, the Republican guy was like, yeah, I'm not sure if being gay is, like, a moral issue or not, but I think it is, and I think we need to look into that. What the fuck are you talking about, boy? What are you talking about, grandpa? What do you mean being gay a moral issue? I asked him the question. They were like, they're 10 questions, like, obviously that's the, like, don't say gay stuff happening in Florida, what's going on with that? And he's like, I'm not sure. And I'm like, yes, you are, boy. And then he came up to me, because that was one of the questions, he came up to me and was like, do you want a picture? And I was like, no, I don't want to, why would I want a picture with you? Why the fuck would I want a picture with you? What are you talking about? No, go away. And then, even, the teacher's like, this dude's fucking crazy. And they turned and was like, you don't need to get in the group picture if you don't want. I'm not getting in that shit. That's gonna come back to haunt me in 10 years. Fuck off. I didn't even get one of the Democratic one either. I'm like, fuck off. I hate politicians. Anyway, this is me at the US Embassy. I mean, that's about it. That happened there. Kendrick Lamar. Look, anyone like my new posters? I've got a bunch of new posters. That's my Everything Everywhere All at Once. Nope. Kendrick Lamar Big Steppers Tour. I've lost the mirror. The mirror's not there. Two. And this is literally Mercury as well. I didn't know what to wear. Fucking love them. Alright, that was enthusiastic. Chill. This is some posters, dude. Where's the After Sun one? It's like so fucking big. There it is. So anyway, I was like that. So then I saw Kendrick with Scott Post. It was really fun. I fucking loved it. It was really, really, really good. I found a cat. I'm pretty sure this dude died. Like, I'm like 99% sure this cat died. Because it was like my friend like brought it home. I bumped into her, she was bringing it home from the vet. And she was like, yeah, it's gonna die soon. It hasn't eaten in like 2 weeks. I'm like, oh, my bad. She's like, do you want a picture with it? I'm like, yeah. I'm like, rest in peace with the cat. I don't know if it's dead or not. I'm not sure if it's dead or not. I haven't spoken to the friend since. Chad, do you want me to drop her a message right now? It looks chill. It was really chill. It was tiny. Like, I could, like... I feel like if, like, I squeezed it, it would pop. Okay. She's called Halima. I'll send her a voice note. Hi, Halima. I just want to say, be careful what you respond to, because I am live right now and it will be played. I was telling my chat about the cat you brought in around school the other day. Oh, it wasn't the other day. It was back in November. And you were like, yeah, but it might die soon. It hasn't eaten in like 2 weeks. I just want to double check. Is the cat still alive? Or did it die? Many thanks. Respond when you can. I'll let you guys know. I'll keep you guys updated. And then, chat. And then I kind of got incredibly depressed. November and like start of December. And I would, chat, run a prediction. Mods, run a prediction. Is the cat dead? I got kicked out of a party. I got kicked out of a party for the first time. But I didn't get kicked out. I got, like, thrown out. Like, almost, like, physically thrown. Basically, chat. Basically. No, Max. I'm not telling the whole story. But I'm telling the first part. I had a little bit to drink. And my friend's 18th, and I'm kind of sitting there. I'm chilling in the garden. And I see this absolute colossal shadow of a man who is like 6'3", stumbling towards me, holding a bowl. A fucking bowl? Are you a monk? Why are you walking around a party carrying a bowl? And he comes down. He comes round to me, and there's like a little table thing next to me here, and I'm kind of sitting there. So there's a table next to me. And he picks up this, but he puts it next to me and walks off. And I go, is that sick? Cause I got a whiff of it. I'm like, is that vomit? Where am I? We're in a garden. I'm like, is that vomit? He's like, yeah. And I was drunk. And I go, I just thought something at the party. And I go, throw it in the garden. Don't put it next to me, you prick. But I didn't say it so aggressively. Yo, Wagwan. I think that's who I think it is. I literally end up getting thrown out like from fucking Fresh Prince. That's literally what happens. That's like exactly what fucking happened. Thank you for the $3 though. So I sit there and I go, throw it somewhere else. Don't put it next to me, you prick. And this guy is literally really good, I guess. Don't call me a prick. I run this house. It's like, whoa. Whoa. Turns out it was the girl's brother. My bad. How was I supposed to know that? Alright? I thought maybe you got held back a couple years. And I was like, oh my god. Oh my god, I'm so sorry now, guy. And I go up and I stand up to apologize and then I trip. And I fall, like, onto him. And I spill his drink down him. No, he didn't vomit a bowl. Someone else vomited a bowl. And I spill his fucking drink down me. And he grabs me and goes, you need to get out now. Because he thinks I did it. Because he thinks I, like, did it on purpose. And I'm like, you need to get out now. And I'm like, what? I'm like, no. And he was, like, walking. And he was like walking me out. I was like, no, I left my elf bar on the table. My makeup was like, no, you need to get out. I walked me to the He walked me to the door and like opens it and literally like fucking like pushes me out. And I'm like, what the hell do I do? And I just kind of stood there. It was like 11:30. The party wasn't ending for 30 minutes. I'm like, I'm not going to wait outside for 30 minutes. So I was literally kind of like standing there. And then I messaged my friends. And I go, is he going to sneak back in? It was likely. I was like, did he really get back in? Did you have friends with you? Yeah, they didn't get kicked out as well, though. And I was like, did you really get back in? Dude, he fucking sat and waited at the door for 30 minutes for me. Like, see if I'd come back. I'm like, Go, like, live your life, man. Go have a fucking drink. What are you doing? Fucking loser. So I end up, like, he was literally, like, spawn camping me. So I'm like, all right, fine, I'll just get an Uber home. And it was really embarrassing. But, like, I apologized, like, the next day. I, like, messaged him, his, like, sister, and he was like, it's chill. He was just, like, really on edge. I'm like, okay, that's fun. That's fun, then. It was just, it was not a fun experience. It was so humbling. Because, like, getting kicked out of a party, what's the second part? I can't tell the second part on stream. There's much more to that story, but that's just Max thinking, there isn't a second part. That's not a second part. I didn't do anything else to get kicked out. It was, maybe I did. But it's, I can't tell on stream now. You looked at the second part. Not on stream. I'm not telling one part of it. Anyway. Basically. Oh, yeah. Oh, no. Yeah, yeah. No, yeah. I told the second part. Basically, chat. Then this is when, like, my depression was at its peak. And I'm like, and then, like, after Sun. And then, like, fuck off, Max. And then, like, after Sun came out of cinema. And I was like, I was so excited for this movie. I'm going to go watch After Sun. Chat, it killed me. Chat, the movie killed me. I know it's because I was in my peak of my depressive episode. Chant, After Sun, the credits rolled, and I cried until the end of the credits, and a worker had to come in and ask me if I was okay. Hi, Bison. I was crying so much. A worker, a cleaner had to come in and ask if I was okay watching After Sun. And I go, yeah, I'm fine. I get on the bus, and this is me on the bus crying on the way home. And I was like, what the hell? I was like, what the hell? And then I tell people that, and they go, oh my god, what's After Sun about? And it's like, it's literally like a dude going on holiday with his daughter. But like, it's more than that, but like, if you dumb it down, that's all the film is. So, and everyone's like, oh, okay. No, okay, you guys should, it's really fun. It's not a fun movie, it's a great movie. It's probably my favourite of the year. And then obviously it was November, so I do No Shave November. I thought I would look like a cool hipster. I look like I wasn't allowed in a primary school's chat. I had to wear like an ankle bracelet. It was bad. It was bad, but I stuck to it. I stuck to it. I think if I went for another month, I could have cooked a little bit. But like, oh shit. But like, I don't know. It's a bit peak. And that brings us on to December. Where only a few minor things happened. And one very major thing. Dad, I got a story for you. Dad, have I got a story for you? Oh my god. Oh my god, I got a multiple story for you. I need to tell you this, and I need to tell you about what happened to my fucking, Chad, I didn't get home till 1 p.m. today. I didn't get home till 1 p.m, and I went out at 8 o'clock last night. Okay, Chad, it has been a crazy month for the place. Chad, I am sitting in class, and my friend walks in, fucking stinks of weed, like stinks, and I'm like, how much, and he's like, what the fuck, how much have you got on you? Like, I think he was selling it to someone, and he goes, oh, like 14 grams. I'm like, in school? He's like, yeah, man, 9 o'clock though, 9 o'clock. It took an hour before he got pulled out of lesson, and they took his shit. And I was like, okay, well, that's peak for him. That's peak for him, but it's whatever. So I'm in period two, period three economics. Can Harry come to the sixth form administration office. I'm like, yeah, I can do that. That's easy. I don't know what my correlation to this is though. And I do that. They make me sit there. They put a phone on the desk. They make me sit there for an hour and a half. They were doing like CIA interrogation tactics on me. They made me sit there in fucking silence for an hour and a half. And I'm like, okay, all right. And then they call me into the room, and I'm sure you know what this is about. And I was like, I have my suspicions. But I played dumb. I'm like, yeah, okay, yeah. I'm like, yeah, sure. I know what you're about. They go, we want you to write a statement. I'm gonna write a statement. And I'm like, okay, sure. About what? About everything. Everything? What the fuck? That's vague. That's a really vague thing for me to write a statement about. I'm like, I'll write a statement about everything. And I just told the story of what happened today. I'm like, okay. And I gave it to him. They go, are you sure that's it? We've gone through his phone. We've screened everything. I was like, okay. I'm like, all right. Yeah, sure. That's all it is. Okay, they're like, cool. They make me sit in silence for another hour. But I look in the other room. There's about 10 other people. So I'm like, it's not just me. And it's all right. It's not just me. And then they call me back in. And they reach under the desk. And they pull out a black and white printed iPhone screenshot of his banking app. Of me sending this guy money. And I probably sent him like £60 over like 4 months. Right. And we're not going to get into the dilly-dallying of what the money was about, because that's not important. It was Ubers. I was going to just do money for Ubers. I'm like, what's this for? I'm like, it's Ubers. I'm like, okay. Well, this is a police investigation now. And I'm like, all right. I'm like, okay. What have you got on me? That's what I said. I was like, okay. Sure, it could be a police investigation. What are they gonna do? They don't give a fuck. Can I not get any Ubers anymore? And they're like, okay. I got like 3 days off of lessons. They didn't want me talking to anyone. They didn't want me doing this. They didn't want me doing anything. They thought I was involved in a drug running ring. Like in the school. Like the school was doing a drug running ring. And we were like giving out like tasters to like year sevens and like getting like hooked on crack or something. I'm like, what are you doing? What's wrong with you? No, what's fucking, like, how are you so fucking stupid? You think that, like, what are you, it's like one dude sold a bit of weed. Like that's it. Like it was so, and they got so pissy about it to the point where this was literally only like, it was like 2 weeks ago. I was meant to be given, like student of the year in the rewards assembly, and they didn't. They I got shown the spreadsheet where it was my name, and then the day before they like changed it. So I'm like, because everyone knew. Actually, I'm in the clear now. Like, I'll continue running drugs. Everyone knew. Everyone was like, this Harry dude's never been lessons. What's he doing wrong? Hi, mate. I don't know why I put gum in. You guys don't want to hear me chew. That was disgusting. I'm sorry. And they got like really fucking pissy about it. And I'm like, this is such an incredibly like minor thing. However, that was police investigation number one. And then last night was a very eventful night, chat. Last night was very eventful. It was Georgia, the girl, the very incredibly rich girl, who I went to Halloween party. It's like, we're doing a Happy New Year party. We're doing a New Year's party. I'm like, that's so chill, man. That's so chill. I love a New Year's party. Have a couple drinks. Yeah, I'll be there. I'll be there. And then I get added. I get added to an Instagram group chat first. And there were probably like 30 people in it. Where was it? Oh, I can't find it. There were probably 30 people in it. So I'm like, all right, okay. Like, it'll be fun. It'll be nice. It'll be a small thing. And then I get added to this shared Snapchat group. Snapchat story. And I was like, oh, it'll be like the same amount of people. I'm going to shitpost in there a bit. And I was like, and I said to him, I was like, what's the policy of having a wank at the end of your garden? And I came home from work. I checked my phone. I got like 16 replies to this story. I was like, what? I checked how many views it had. Chad, I got 110 views. And I was like, oh my god, it's like a New Year's party. It's like a euphoria. It's like a high school musical job. Calm. Chad, I arrived yesterday. It was crazy. Chad, those private school people, man, do they love... I'm pretty sure I saw someone smoking crack. I'm being so honest. I was really, really drunk, and there was a queue for the toilet because everyone was doing coke in there. And I had to stumble to the end of the garden, and I found a bush. And I don't know if my brain made this up. I swear I saw a dude with a crack pipe. I'm like, all right, man, like, that's your life. You want to smoke crack, you can smoke crack. That doesn't affect... we should all smoke crack. So I'm like, I'm with him on that. Go to smoke crack. I didn't have a wank in the garden, I just needed a piss. And then I'm in the bathroom, with a couple friends. No, I'm in the bathroom by myself. And I had this bottle of Malibu, and, oh my god, no, Chad, I'm in this bottle of Malibu, and I step backwards, and I knock it off the fucking sink, and the bottom of it cracks, and I've, like, this smashed, I like, kind of cut myself on it, and it's smashed, and I'm like, shit, man, I'd already had a bit of drink. I'm like, okay, I know how I'm gonna get around this. I won't just hold the bottle upside down so I can sip out. I'm like, I'm gonna hold this bottle of straight Malibu, like, above, oh my god, no, whoa, that doesn't look good. I was like, I'm gonna drip it into. I was in the bathroom about 3 minutes, drinking like straight Malibu, like dripping out of this crack. I definitely consumed some glass. There's some glass in my stomach, I'm gonna be honest. Happy New Year, Gumpy. I love you. So I'm like, all right. So I do that. Was it flavored? No, it's just Malibu. It's like coconut. It's like coconut white rum. I love a bit of Malibu, Chad. I love it. So I'm like, all right, that's chill. I'm so chill. I wasn't chill. New Year's happens. I'm having fun. Chad, I got a New Year's kiss. And then I'm like, it's 2 a.m. now. And I'm like, I've come from a fucking work shift. I'm a bit tired. I'm sitting on the sofa. I had my two friends with me. I'm like, sitting there, and I'm like, I'm gone. I'm so gone. Like, I'm actually gone. And I'm like, and all of a sudden everything goes really quiet. And I'm like, whoa, because they had like a DJ. My friend Chad Eve was DJing. My everything goes really quiet, and then. Well, you know, like, you can see, like, light through your eyes when they're shut. Like, someone turned the lights on. And I'm there. And I open my eyes. And there's four police officers. Standing. Right in front of me. Fuck. And I'm like, you're right. And I'm like, you're right. And I go, yeah, you. I go, yeah, you. Oh yeah, you to leave. Basically, neighbours had called the police because people were shooting fireworks at each other. Like, you need to leave. And I'm like, okay. And I go, I'm like, okay, and I like grab my ventilator and walk out so fucking fast. I've never walked out so fucking fast in my life. And I was like the adrenaline like sobered me up. I was like, I can do anything right now. And I was like, I need to get an Uber. I just go around my friend's house. It's like in fucking like Croydon. And I didn't get home until like 2 p.m. I was like, Chad, it was, what a stressful night, man. Oh my God, what a stressful night. I mean, apart from that, whatever happened in December. Chad, me and Bill linked up. I stayed around Bill's. When I went to the James gig. I spoke about it earlier. I actually can't talk about it. Me and Bill, there's some stuff. There's some stuff going on. There's some stuff. But I literally can't talk about it. But you'll see. Chad, you'll see. Chad, you'll see. Is the cat dead? He responded. Oh! Chat, we got a voice note back. It's only 5 seconds.
Oh my God, well, hi. And, no, the cat died. It died like 3 weeks ago.
Oh, man. Well, I'm sorry to hear that. Hope you had a good new year, though. Love you. Alright, roll the prediction, guys. Who's winning points? Who got the most? 180k? What? Is the cat dead? 412k goes to Kaplamu? Damn. Yeah, no, the cat died. Like, that shit's long gone. I think it's just like it's like a comedic, like, skeleton now. Did you predict someone's cat died? Yeah, you bet on a cat dying. It wasn't my idea, guys. It's my morally corrupt mods. That's what it was. So, Chad, pretty much that's what I've been up to. I became normal for like 6 months. That's a prediction for a cat's death. Yeah, because basically, for anyone who missed it, where's the cat? This cat chat. Queer Germany, think of the 3 months. I bumped into my friend who's come back from the vet, and she was like, yeah, I think the cat's gonna die, so it hasn't eaten in like 3 weeks. And it did end up dying. But we didn't know. We were just waiting. Is he Kendrick alive? I did, yeah. Then what? What else have I got? I got new posters. I changed my Kanye one, for obvious reasons, to Tyler. I got a Nope one, Everything Everywhere All at Once, and like a signed Amino one, but you've had that one for ages. Yeah, like a lot has happened. Did you guys miss me, chat? Did you guys ever cry yourself to sleep knowing I... Did you guys get really sad? Nope. No? Nah? No? Okay. Sad about what? Me not streaming? So many people thought I was like 100% quitting. And I'm like, fuck you guys. Fuck you guys for not believing in me. Happy New Year, love cats. Guys, New Year, new me. New Year, new me. No, I'm playing. Are you going to respond to this? Didn't work. Had it on low volume, bitch. Had it on low volume, bitch. Oh my God, yeah, chat, Mini Mentor came in. Oh my God. Hi, Emmy. Mini Mentor, like from the Sideman, I dropped a television on him, which is fun. I got, oh, yeah, okay. Chad, I am bringing up a television from the warehouse at Argos, and it's like busy. This is like fucking like it was Christmas Eve. It was Christmas Eve, busy as a motherfucker, and I got this television and I bumped into someone, and I basically fucking dropped it on his foot, and I pick it up and I go, oh my God, I'm so sorry. Let me pull up the photo. I go, I'm so sorry, man. I'm actually so sorry, and I look up. It's Simon Mini Minter, like from the Sidemen. And I'm like, I was like, and then, And I don't know what to do. I go, he was with his girlfriend. It was his girlfriend, Talia, like the singer. And I go, Chad, I have pictures. And I go, oh, I'm so sorry, man. Love the videos. And he's like, cheers. And I'd like walk off. Local James. And then I go back into the room. And I'm like, dude, I just dropped a fucking television on Simon Miniminter. Like, no, they're like, no, you didn't. They're like, don't take the piss. And I'm like, wait, hold on. I'll find the picture. It wasn't Christmas Eve, was it? And I was like, my friend, my other coworker went and got a picture of him. I was genuinely too embarrassed to like spin back around again and get it. Hold on, I need to censor what Argos I work at. But Chad, that's my coworker who got a picture with him. Cause I was too embarrassed. That's Freddy. That was genuinely a true story, and it was so fucking embarrassing. Dick from Dick and Dom, really? You know they DJ now, Dick and Dom? My brother saw him in, like, Brighton. And I'm like, that's chill. That's so chill. But yeah, that happened. I think that's all the stories, really. I don't know. Not much has been going... That's a lie. Especially as long as her. Yeah. Have you got any resolutions? I want a six pack. I want a six pack. That's my resolution. Oh my god, do I got people offering chat? Khan, fuck off. Hi Khan. Hi. No, I mean that's it. Chad, how have you been? With a dress story? No, you don't. That's a bad one. Are your A-levels going okay? Good question. Can we ask another one? Can we move on? Can we please move on? I don't want to talk about that. No, I'm really happy you guys don't hate me. I was scared I'd go live and I'd get like 10 viewers. And I was like, this is nice. I actually haven't checked my view count the whole stream. But I'm like, you guys have... Chad's moving fast. Chad's moving fast-ish. So thanks. Guys, we got the 30 subs this stream. I'm gonna helicopter so fast, I'm gonna hover around my room. You were gone? Yeah. Let's fucking go. Come on guys. Let's get the No, so tell me now's your stream again. Aw, thanks guys. I think I'm meeting up with Katie Bugs tomorrow. Kingsley Ghost, Max? Is that your name? I'm an awful person named Max. Kingsley Ghost, thank you for the prime. I remember you. What did you... Abby! Holy shit, wait, Abby, you donated before. And I didn't even see. I'm actually an awful person. What the fuck? Abby, I literally won't let me see it because I'm not logged in. Hold on. Mage, thank you for the tier 1. Do it now. Have I hit it? Hold on, one moment. Chad, you need to give me a second. I got a donation, but I'm trying to figure out what the tweet is. Let me cook. Oh, this happened too. The video finally came out. Hold on, one second. The video finally came out, chat. I was in the Nico video, and my teeth look dead in it. I look so fucking grim. Ignored my sub. Oh my god! Chocolate, thank you for the tier 1. Amazing, thank you for the tier 1. Hope you get $1 million. What? So do I. Colin, thank you for the 9 months. Oh, GMCW! Yeah! Thank you for the 19 months. All right, guys. 30 subs. I'm going back to the helicopter. Oh, I'm joking. I'm 17. Chad, I'm 17. What's wrong with you guys? Oh! I actually... This is television. I had quite a lot to drink. Yesterday, I came home with wet socks in a bag. Where'd I put them? Where'd I put my bag of wet socks? I was on my desk. I don't know. Oh. This shit spawned in my pocket. Is it just one? Does anyone want it? Are they yours? Yeah, they're mine. They're covered in hair. I don't know, sniff? You guys are all going to prison. You guys need to be executed, bag over the head, shot in the back of the head. You fucking freaks. Do a raffle. Guys, be honest, would you guys give me your address so I can send you wet socks or not? Guys, be honest with me. Oh, I did this stream. I did this stream, then I did the stream with Bill. I did the Billzo stream as well. Which was really... I just literally stopped giving a fuck. No way they posted... So I had the raise. Come on, man. You know me. They call me the White Boy Yardie. Man. Alright, guys. I got my subs. I'm never streaming again now. Joking. Dude, do a P.O. box. It looks like the Johnny picture. Are you a Johnny fan account? Janana? Get out. I'm about to fucking ban you. I'm actually about to fucking ban you. Answer that question. I'll be so real. Janana, you... Ronnie! Remember the 4 months? Johnny, be dead. Janana, be fucking serious with me right now. I'm pausing the music. I'm waiting. I'm checking your chat logs in Johnny's chat. If you have more than 150, you're getting permanently excluded. Yeah, you're getting excluded. No, my name is Jonna. Do I believe you? I want to believe you. Oh, why'd I put your name in there? I want to believe you.
I know, once again, contrary to the entire internet, Brits, sad.
Chat, you know, this is some big. People,
they just don't.
Alright. Don't
pick it up what I'm putting down. It's all that right. Simple.
I'm going to say yo.
It's.
Yo, J-Bag.
I never thought you were gay. Well, care to explain how this whole kerfuffle started? Really interesting. Yo, J. Harry, don't say J-Bag. I found out what the word J-Bag meant. I looked it up on Urban Dictionary. You've been calling it me for the past year. That's genuinely one of the fucking, like, shit things you've ever said to me. Literally fucking ever.
Okay, you know, if J-Bag was just like a nickname I came up for John A. You know, I always used to call him J-Bag. And he'd go, oh my god, hi, Harry. And he just went along with it. So, J-Bag is oriented in England. A J-Bag is a slut, whore, slag, or sket. I saw your girlfriend giving slobstone in the park yesterday. Sorry, bro. Oh my god, what a fucking J-Bag. And he just thought I was like a cool one I'd written up for him. He went along with it. And I was like, I almost felt bad when he found out. Because I actually just started calling him it like as a nickname. It lost all meaning. Because no one really calls J-Bag. It's like Neek. No one says Neek. We need to bring back Neek. We need to bring back bullying. Like, I'm so serious. No, I'm not. I'm not. I love Neek. I call everyone a Neek. Can remember like the most insulting thing was calling someone a fat Neek? I was thinking, people in like year 7, year 8, people referred to me more as fat Neek than they did Harry. It was like that. I think that gave me like intense confidence issues. Should you do anything for your school? Yeah. I have 3 sources of income, guys. I'm a hustler. I haven't called someone a Neek. Yeah, because you're fucking Swedish. I never someone call him a Neek. I only hear him call him Inga Dinga Durgan. Fuck off, Rex. Sorry. I would have Neek by one of your mates. Yeah, but... I, like, if you do Neeky stuff... If you do nitty stuff, you can get called a nitty. Why didn't you do this? Guys, imagine I came back as like a full like MCYT. Like, imagine I came back and I was like, we're playing Bed Wars today, chat. Open lobby, YouTube rank, open party. And public SMP, guys. Who are you talking about public SMP? And I become like a PNG tuber. Shinlord Willow! Over the 3 months. 5'11"? Can we update that? I got something to show you guys. Where the fuck is my... Where is my wallet? Oh my god, where's my wallet? I had it in my wallet. I got my height, like, actually measured by one of the machines. I'm 5'11", 0.3. Can someone add the 0.3? Can someone add the 0.3 in there? Also, okay, I don't know who runs... Chad, who runs average updates? Because... Oh, Mr. Beast DM'd me! That's his penis. I was about to show on my stream, that's Mr. Beast DM'd... Chad, Mr. Beast DM'd me his penis. Hold on, let me censor it. I'll show you guys. Guys, why did Mr. B send me this? Adrena Borg! Why did Mr. B send me this? I'm gonna send that in Chungus. He's giving to the poor. He's giving his wood to the poor. Oh my god, Chad, that was like a TikToker I was talking to yesterday. That was this dude who's like, apparently he's called like Da Wood. And he was at that party yesterday. Oh, I don't even know his fucking TikTok, man. But he had like 300k on TikTok or some shit. And I was like, that's chill, man. I don't know what the reaction he wanted from me, I'll be honest. But like, good for him. Harry, for some reason, our first, and I think our Discord DM is me sending you someone's dick. What? Are you Mr. Beast? Mage. Was going to tag you in this, but Crow won't let me. Oh my god. That's a really big dick. Why'd you send me that? That's too much dick, I'd argue. It's like sometimes I see some ass. No, I haven't even got enough dick for all of that. That's a big ass. I can do that. I wouldn't be able to do that. Yeah, do that. Guys, can someone donate $20 for Mr. Beast? I'll send it to him. Guys, I'll send it to him. I will. I promise, everyone. See, Mr. Beast pissing in your urinal. Have you guys seen Ryan Gosling pissing? I love that photo so much. I love Ryan Gosling pissing. Is that real? I don't think it's real. I think it's photoshopped. Hold on, chat. I'll find it. Hold on. Everybody loves the sunshine. Hold on. Oh. Everybody loves the sunshine. Is this it?
Deku, you can call me Deku. Can we get much higher?
Chat, watch that. Chat, watch that. Guys, watch the video. Huh? That was good. I actually couldn't believe it. I don't think it's real. I'm pretty sure it's edited, though. I'm pretty sure it's edited. Dude, you know what lyric I actually relate to so fucking highly? Where is it? Hold on.
Come like they forgot their boots. Them man, they're selected bad boys. I really don't know how they pick and choose. The whole gang spent bands on boots. Them man, all I do is organize orders. Come like I work in Argos.
That's me! That's me! I organize orders and I work in Argos. And RFP did score so many goals this season, they did win a golden boot. He mentioned me. He actually did. He's just like me. People say me and Heady One actually look really similar to that. Why is John listening to Tom McDonald in the activity bar? What the hell? Is that Tom McDonald? Oh, let me play it. I don't think that's a... Wait, this is what John is listening to, chat.
Think it's crazy I'm the one who they labeled as controversial, and Cardi B is the role model for 12-year-old girls. There's rappers pushing Xanax at the top of the billboard, but if I mention race in a song, I'm scared I'll get killed for it. It's backwards, it's getting exponentially.
Guys, he's not. I was really scared I lost my funny. You know, that I was terrified. I was terrified that I would come back and I'd be the most fucking boring cunt ever. I'm really happy you guys dropped an Omega Lull every now and then. It means the world. Is this real? No, he's not. He seems like some fucking extreme shit, man. Man. Like I'm Johnston, if I don't have some tapeworms, they're gonna eat him out. I'm not gonna say it. I'm not gonna say it. Do a handstand now? Oh! No! 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 No, I don't want to do a handstand because, I don't wear these and I low key, I'm sitting in a leather chair and my room's really hot and it might look like I've shit myself. No one give you guys access to that in it again. Hit the Luddy. I don't know how. I actually don't know how. I'll be so real. I actually don't know how. How do you hit the Luddy? Luddy video.
I made everyone at Abe and Wendy's wedding hit the Luddy.
How? That's... I don't know. From where, chat? Where is it? Is it that way? How do I do that? Is it big on footwork? Is footwork a big part of this? I'm not good with footwork, Chad. I'm not Muhammad Ali. I'ma show you how great I am! Great I am! This kid's about to be the greatest thing I've ever seen. I wanna fly, can you take me far from here? Give me a shot. Alright. I know what I'm doing. How do I hit the line? I went on for way too long. How do you hit the Luddy? Kai hits the hardest Luddy ever. Oh, damn, that motion track this point. Oh. So it's it. Fuck! Oh. Shit, man. Hold on, chat. I'm gonna cook. You're gonna let me cook here.
MC, make a you want.
Project, project,
this ain't what you want. This ain't what you want.
Oh,
1600 block. I just wanna rock. I just wanna.
Let me go.
I just wanna rock.
Let me go.
Body out of ya. Shorty got that body out of ya. Hit it once, no time. Side up, fuck, you gon' kill my vibe. Stand on my money, don't know my size. Pick them sides, and you better choose wisely. That's my high. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's my high. Damn!
Ladies, don't get too wet. Alright. Alright. That's a one. Yeah, I cooked. I didn't cook. I just... Big Mrs. Baker Street, I just read it. It's Pudding Lane. It's just the Tower of London Bridge. It's Tower of Burning. It's the fire of London, it's big. That's what's going on. That's what's going on. Chat, I'm hench now as well. Look. Look at that. You guys missed a lot. I'm getting a six-pack soon, I think. Jerry Salmonella, chat, next stream I'm gonna cook. I'm gonna practice, I'm gonna sit in my room for hours. They should give me Salmonella, it wasn't even fucking salmon. Oh, Halima sent another voice note, chat.
Oh my god, I had such a good new year. Oh, look at him, happy new year.
That was in English.
Oh my god, I had such a good new year. Oh, look at him, happy new year.
Alright, I was more hoping for more about the dead cat. My bad. I watched a Whitney Houston film the other day. It was really gay. I don't think she was that gay. She was. I mean, good for her. My friend worked in the movie, really? It was okay. Tell him that. Don't tell him that. That's really mean. Don't tell him that. Tell him I was incredible, man. Man. Could we serve? Oh my god, I forgot I did that. I haven't seen it. It's alright. It's so mediocre. You seen the Avatar? I haven't. Because I want to rewatch the first Avatar beforehand. But like, that is like 6 hours of my time I need to fucking dedicate to Avatar. And I'm like, come on, man. I got better things to do. What if I want to jerk off? What do I want to jerk off, man? How's your Disney trip? I streamed when I came back from that. I went for it, didn't I? It was awesome. Chad, I love America to visit. I think I'd kill myself if I had to live there, man. We gotta get you guys out of there. We've actually gotta save you guys. Man. Miz gives back at OTK. Yeah, I think I was still incredibly drunk when that statement dropped. I actually didn't read it. But, like, OTK's washed now. Literally, like, now that, like, Schlatt's gone, who's the good people in OTK? Like, guys, Tectonic. Guys, Tectonic. It's like Bruce and Emmy. That's it. It's like everyone else is just like, it's like rape defenders. I'm like, this is a washed org. Shout out Bruce though. On September 20th, OTK began the process of contracting a third party law firm to, I don't know why I'm doing this voice, it's actually really serious. I don't know what that was. On September 20th, OTK began the process of, so I'm nervous. I'm so incredibly nervous. The conduct and allegations made against one of our founding members, Mizkiff. We proceeded to retain Jackson Walker, one of the largest, most experienced neutral investigation firms in the state. The scope of the investigation determined whether or not Mizkiff attempted to cover up or minimize a sexual assault allegedly committed by one of his former roommates. Jackson Walker was granted free reign to gather all relevant facts, interview instances, and advise OTK. Mizkiff was placed on unpaid leave. According to Jack Walker, the Investigation Council did not find direct evidence that Mizkiff... He literally did, though, didn't he? This fucking LLP sucks, dude. They needed me in there. I knew the answer. He's a wrong'un. That's the fucking answer. Jackson Walker literally, Stonepaw saying this is as for the statement dropped is crazy.
What did Stonepaw say? We got those OTK investigators, bro. We are not getting this. We're never getting the statements released. Stonepaw, I'm sorry for misspeaking and saying that you have sex with animals.
I love Axel. I love Axel. OTK believes that Mizkiff has shown a callous disregard towards the severity of sexual illness and racial prejudice in our space. His statement regarding these matters on his comeback stream, October 11, demonstrated a lack of empathy and ignorance towards the seriousness of the situation and the impact that conduct has on our community. Due to his board, the OTK board of directors, it's like Esvand. It's like Esvand and Rich. What the fuck is the OTK board of directors? Fuck off, dude. Has suspended Mizkiff. Like, you're a gaming org. You're OTK. You guys are Esvand and Asmongold. And, like, they good McDonald's together. They, like, picked up Chick-fil-A and, like, drove around. What are you talking about? And if we play... Suspended Mizkiff, board of duties effectively replaced on monitored probation. Until he demonstrates to the board that he's capable of upholding our organization. No, none of them are capable of upholding the organization values. They're all wrong-uns. They're all wrong-uns. He says OTK members have otherwise been reinstated. OTK stands firmly against sexual harassment. Okay. Okay. Assault and bigotry of all forms. And is committed to upholding its core values of equality, respect, and inclusivity. Yes, guys. Guys, OTK, you know, equality, respect, and inclusivity.
Come on, no R word. Listen, I think there's nothing wrong with saying the word retarded, and I think that the people that get
damn, I meant to pause that shit earlier. I didn't mean to. I wasn't planning on letting him let it rip, but I was clicked on the wrong tab. My bad. Yeah, guys. Yeah. Reaction time of a snail. Fuck off. OTK stands firmly against sexual harassment, still big different forms. We associate support of our community. God, he's so fine. I hope you glad my stummy rumbles. Tangsy, no. Put your stummy up to the screen. Now, you better stop. I know you better stop. You better stop hurting. Or I'm gonna have a problem. I can't do it. I'm sorry. Did you see the Michaela tweet? I hope Michaela. I'm like, I can't. I hope Michaela. Dies. What's this?
MC.
Wait, did I cook? Oh, hold on.
This ain't what you want.
Project.
This ain't what you want. This ain't what you want.
Whoa, let me cook. Wait, let me cook. It's because I didn't get the footwork. The footwork wasn't in time with everything else. I was low-key. This shit was on 2 ping. This shit was on 84. All right. There was mobile delay. There was mobile delay. And there's nothing wrong with that. I needed more foot. I need to work on the footwork. Oh my god. Wallace and Vomit. That's a nice name. Leave the follow. I had to work on the footwork. We have 6 months of TikToks to get up on. This is big. That's really big. Benedict Cumberbatch, his family, could face legal pressure from Barbados to pay reparations due to his ancestors running a slave plantation of 250 people. Abolition of slavery resulted in his family receiving compensation from the UK government, about $1 million in today's money. That's fucking insane. Oh my god. Damn. Well, charge it, man. Reparations are reparations. Holy smokes. Holy smokes. Have we got more Doherty Dozen? Have there been more Doherty Dozen roll calls? What the hell is this? Doherty Dozen, Neva arrested?
Rumor has it he's the one I'm leaving you for.
Let's talk about the Doherty Dozen. If you've never heard of the Doherty Dozen before, they are a huge family that have a mix of adopted, fostered, and biological children. And they have a YouTube channel where they post vlogs and shopping hauls and things like that. But all hate, all snark...
It's pronounced Doherty, by the way. Is that going to go and drama with that person? Is that going to go and... Jack, going to drama with that person on Twitter? And I said, it's average Harry, it's spelled with one word. It's like about like Brooke Frognor. And then they actually beat my ass. They jumped my ass on Twitter. I just got like 200 quad tweets. I'm like, damn, my bad. You got angry. Someone didn't want to meet up with you. Fucking cry. No, Chad. I'm good, man. I'm chill now. I'm not problematic.
Excuse me, bro.
You're excused.
Excuse.
And I'm not your bra.
And I'm not your bra.
Christmas.
That's actually crazy, because this dude doesn't look inbred at all. He actually doesn't fit in. Everyone else looks a little... They got a little bit, like, fetal alcohol syndrome in them. Him and, like, his sister, Neva, are, like, the two, like, most normal-looking people. We need to free them. We need to free them from the Doherty Dozen, okay? He's one of the adopted... fucking clearly, he's black. They're both black. We'd be weird. I'd be crazy if he wasn't. Nevaeh. It's Nevaeh, yeah. Like, we need to get him out.
Here's what my 12 kids ate today on Christmas Day.
Am I crazy with, like, milk? I was just like four cans of milk.
For breakfast, we had German pancakes, honey-baked ham, pastries, bagels, and grapes. For lunch, we had subs, wraps, sandwiches... Boneless wings.
I'm about to kill my parents. No, I'm coming north and I need to get adopted, chat. I'll be so real. That's all for Alex.
A chick pizza, cheese, and pepperoni pizza. Then Nana brought over crepes, bacon-wrapped chestnuts, puff pastries, cookies, and...
Puff pastries? It's just the mac and cheese pastries.
Fudge. For a snack, we had a sushi platter, shrimp cocktail, veggies, and pretzel bites. For dinner, we had mac and cheese, pulled pork, chicken parm, pasta,
chicken parm,
and...
bitch, that's like 12 chicken parms. What is this? Bitch, you play Jenga with the chicken palms. That is not chicken palm. Wrapping Christmas presents for my 12 kids. A head strap. It's done, Kat.
Here's what my 12 Christmas kids Eve. Ate today on Christmas Eve. For breakfast, I made Christmas tree cinnamon rolls with apples and bacon. For lunch,
that makes me. Why is it like that? Chad, do you think she's like stacked them up? She would have had to.
Yeah, chili cheese dogs.
Do they serve that bitch out the pot?
4 o'clock,
wallow himself. You look like that? See, I told you, they are inbred. It's like a weird incest family. Bollock. Damn, I mean to cling your shit. Bollock. That's like a cute name. Yo.
Trying to prank my 4-year-old with Gig Git.
It's Anne Frank. This one, this package from Ted Kaczynski. She breathes like a bug. She's 4 years old. Chad, Harley, throw back to Harley's pregnancy announcement. What? Whoa.
Santa's getting.
Oh. They were pregnant with Holly. That makes more sense. I was like, what the hell? What kind of weird shit is going on in the Doherty Dozen house?
Present. Read it out loud. Mommy and Daddy are on the naughty list.
Teacher.
Mommy and Daddy are on the naughty list. Daddy came in Mommy's pussy. No, there's a kid on the way. That's what were they gonna say? What were they gonna say?
Mommy and Daddy are on the naughty list.
What?
Chad, it's him. Oh, it's the irrelevant one.
Teacher gifts from our 12 kids. This year, the teachers are getting this cute holiday card, plus our signature page.
Yeah, I'm fucking pissed on me if a student gave me his autograph as a Christmas present. Are you fucking serious?
And a tile tracker. We have 32 teachers to gift among 12 kids between 5 different schools.
Yeah, it was fucking sponsored. It was sponsored. They just got, like, sent shit and gave him an autograph as well.
Keychain tile tracker was the perfect idea this year. Because my kid might make you lose your mind, but at least now you won't lose your keys. Thanks, Tile. And stocking stuffers for my 12 kids. One of my favorite things about Christmas are the stockings.
Yeah, man. I fucking love capitalism.
From all of us here at the Doherty Dozen, we want to wish you a happy holiday.
This is literally my sleep paralysis. This is literally my biggest fucking fear. This is my biggest. You know, picture I wake up and I start singing. And I sing like this fucking 4-year-old in my room. I'm like, get out!
Come visit Santa with us. And our 12 kids.
12 kids? Bitch, that is a grown adult. 12 kids? Don't take the piss. That man can drive.
12 kids. We took the kids to visit Santa, and here's what they asked for.
Yeah, you were looking for Christmas.
Yeah. You just asked for a haircut.
Oh, how are you? Okay. You're sleeping. Yeah. Are
you listening?
It's like,
yeah,
if you really
want. Oh, no, he's the fucking goat, though. Okay, he is the goat.
Oh, okay.
A realistic-looking sleeping doll? What? Get this bitch in therapy! What? What is that? Really, a realistic-looking sleeping doll and, like some like, medical tools so I can cut her open. Like some scalpels.
Okay. You want one that's sleeping or I go?
Dash was speaking his native tongue. But hold on, I can probably translate it. Yeah, I heard it. Chad, Dash says he needs motor oil to drink so he can so he can power his spaceship to get back to his own planet.
So tell me what you want for this.
Once we leave Santa's house, we get to take a horse-drawn carriage ride through the town.
What?
It was a cold but festive family fun day.
Oh my god, what? This man's got hose. What? Who's that? Look at what's Alex's account? Medieval ass family. What's his account? Alex has a girlfriend? Well, I assume that. It's not like a random woman off the street.
Costco haul for my family of 14. I quickly filled up the.
It's like 12 microwaves.
First flatbed with 624 bottled waters.
I love capitalism. Bottles of waters? What? Do you guys not have tap water in America?
I grabbed a second flatbed for 312 Gatorades.
You need to be shot. I'll say it. I know it's my comeback steering. I gotta say it, man. I'm tired of this.
300 Sunny D's and 120 Kool-Aids. I left those flatbeds up front and grabbed.
This is all for Alex. This is for a week of Alex. Is this Alex's account? Exactly why you light me up inside like the 4th of July. Whenever you're around, I always seem to smile and be. She's racist. I can tell. He's got a video on his monitor of like rainbow lights. And I'm down to get the friction on. So ladies, yeah. Ladies, yeah. If you wanna roll my Mercedes, yeah. Turn around, stick it out. Even white boys got to shout. Baby got back. Oh, hold on. Is he gonna? Oh! Hold on, Chad. Let him cook. Let him cook. Let him cook. This is me when I threatened to post my penis on Twitter yesterday. She just wanna party, and nothing wrong with that. Every time I'm calling, she say she gonna call me back. I told her call me right. Scott, have you seen it? Max, I showed Max my penis.
I just like tell the truth, like, and tell him the truth.
He's dating to marry.
I just tell the truth, and tell him the truth. Is crazy in a world
full. 15, yeah, I think he's like, he can drive, I'm pretty sure. Who gets the tuna? James. Only one person gets the tuna. How much tuna is that? Tumble out of bed and stumble to the kitchen. Pour myself a cup of ambition and yawn and stretch and try to come. Dude, there are fucking 12 of you. There are 12 of you, and one of them is like 17. Where's the dad?
Here's what my 12 kids ate today. For breakfast, I made Christmas sprinkled.
Fuck off. Where's their Christmas presents?
January.
Where's the 25th?
Christmas haul.
Have a holiday. Hula hoops.
Jolly Christmas.
For it's our 12 the best kids.
Time of the year.
Alex.
I don't know if.
Whoa. Hold on.
There'll be snow.
Did it go Jordan 4s?
I have a cup of.
What the fuck?
Nevea.
Have a holiday, jolly Christmas.
Aww. Patrick.
And when you walk down the street.
iPhone, iPad, Nintendo Switch, snowboard, roller skates.
Be shy.
Say hello.
Yeah, you can have it though. He's a fucking goat, man.
But to friends you know.
Three.
And everyone.
Got the Oreos. Tangy, think of the 7 months. You mean. Dash is gonna get like a bunch of like runes.
Zoe.
Wait, did Holly get a realistic? Oh. That's weird. That's like for Dash to experiment on. That's odd. That's terrifying. I don't want anything. Chad, please don't get me a sleeping baby doll. Ever. a dead baby kid. That's what I wanted.
You mean.
Daddy's gonna get some gizmos, and he's gonna be really angry if he gets some gadgets.
Zoe.
Oh, the mistletoe is hung.
That's got a head strap. What for? It's only gonna attach it to his UFO. It's like it controls it for his mind.
Where you can
Jordan.
See.
Why Dash can knife when he's five?
Some.
What the? A fucking arcade machine?
Jesus.
Oh, we got an Oculus. Oh.
For you, kiss her once for me.
Bodhi.
Okay, those are kind of hard. I don't know why they need them. I don't know why he needs an iPad and an iPhone.
Harley.
Surely hot. Dude, she's like five. Hi, Linny. Linny, thank you 11 months. I can't wave that down. I don't think five-year-olds need an iPad and an iPhone. She literally Harley has a better phone than me.
Taking Deshaun to Build-A-Bear for the first time, he picked out a brown bear with a red heart.
What? That's so lame. He should have got Paw Patrol.
Then filled it with stuffing.
He's cooking.
Gotta make sure it's nice and huggable.
Hug that. Oh. Next, he actually
he
is the guy.
A heart.
Get him out. Get out, Alex. You're ruining it.
Did the heart ceremony before putting it in the bear. Then he gets the Build-A-Bear bath. And he picked out a cute soccer outfit. Gave it a birth certificate.
Do I live in Buffalo? I don't know. I'm not up to date on the law. How? He's 13, really?
And got him dressed. That's it for today.
No, Alex got one as well, and he dressed it like himself. That's weird. Do you think he gave it to his girlfriend? Yeah.
Santa looking real sus.
Good one, Dash. Good one. How is Santa looking sus? Let him do his job. This dude couldn't afford shoes now. Santa's not wear that. His tootsies will get cold. New York City highlight roll call. Alex, what was your highlight of New York City? 9/11.
He does an NYC highlight
Alex,
roll call.
The best part of NYC.
Seeing the Music Man.
James.
The Music Man. Who's the everyone loves, who's the Music Man?
The best part of NYC.
Music Man.
Nevaeh, what was the best part of NYC?
I think he smokes a pack a day.
Best part of NYC.
Music Man.
Nevaeh, what was the best part of NYC?
The circus.
Patrick, what was the best part of NYC?
The circus.
Deshaun, what was the best part of NYC?
Spending time with him.
That's why he's the fucking goat. The best to ever do it. The best to ever do
Bree, what was the best part of NYC?
Johnny, he's like a homeless man who kept asking for money.
Zoe, what was the best part of NYC?
Music Man.
Dash, what was the best part of NYC?
What's the going? Being able to charge my UFO at a Tesla charging point.
Jordan, what was the best part of NYC?
Singing indoors.
Jason, what was the best part of NYC?
Eminem
song. Bodhi, what was the best part of NYC? Carly, what was the best part of NYC?
Wait, Holly's hair's grown.
A hotel.
Doherty does.
Yeah, you get a hotel anywhere. Is Dash just Stewie Griffin? He's like really, he's actually really smart. And Alex is Brian. Are they getting a security escort? What is this? Are they getting watched? Are they getting watched? The other ones are getting watched by security?
What you know about me? What you know about me?
This is definitely Trump Tower. And it's definitely owned by Alex's girlfriend. No, this man is the goat, though. Same with Nevaeh.
Here's what my...
Doherty Dozen Big Apple Circus Highlight Roll Call.
Alex, what was your favorite part of that Big Apple Circus?
Johnny.
James, what was...
Pete. I like Pete.
What's your best part of the circus?
Johnny.
Nevaeh, what's your best part of the circus?
A hula hoop dancer.
Patrick, what was your best part of the circus?
Johnny.
Deshaun, what was your best part of the circus?
Johnny.
Maybe Johnny's valid then. Maybe Johnny's valid.
Bree, what was your best part of the circus?
Johnny.
Zoe, what was your best part of the circus?
The dog trainer.
Dash, what was your best part of the circus?
Johnny.
Jordan, what was your best part of the circus?
Johnny.
Jason, what was your best part of the circus?
Johnny.
Bodie, what was your best part of the circus?
Johnny.
Harley, what was your best part of the circus?
Johnny. Yeah, we need to free Nevaeh. I'll be so real. What is the circus? NYC Circus, Johnny. Johnny the Clown at the Big Apple Circus. Imagine it's just like a promotional for like Terrifier 3. What's up, Bob the Bob? Putting a fucking broom on his nose? Are you serious? This is a homeless method they pulled up. It's like a crack ad.
Full of lies.
No, we ain't giving no hope. I ain't Romeo and I'll hold.
A party, chocolate party, they're all still tweaking. I want to check in on him. I want to check in. Really good.
No, we ain't
I know it's probably taking like 40 attempts to do.
Here's what my 12th.
Don't say Nevaeh's gonna come.
We gonna light it up.
Oh, wait!
She won't put that on me, put it on me. Come and pull up on me, make sure that they're done.
Getting with the gritty again.
Woo! We did
it up. Out of all the reindeers, you know you're the mastermind.
Gotta get the friction on, so ladies, yeah. Ladies, yeah. If you wanna roll my Mercedes, yeah. Turn around, stick it out. Even white boys got the shout, baby got.
Come get your nails done with. Here's what my 12 kids ate today.
Egypt? For. What is Egypt? Where? What? In Egypt? This is your house.
Breakfast. I made breakfast wraps with bananas. For lunch, I packed them a sandwich, fruit cup water, yogurt.
Island, yeah.
And Velveeta mac and cheese. I made them an after school snackerty board to share. And dinner was a round the world night where we made foods from Egypt.
Oh.
Shawarma, kusamashi, and falafel.
Are you Egyptian? I think shawarma was. I don't think that was Egyptian, was it?
Bust down on the gang.
Cardian. I was home with my kid, Mami Yan.
That's New Yorkian, cuh.
Feeding my.
Monday mini vlog. With James.
It's that time of week where I take
one. James, they have to take a break because he wants to go smoke a pack of fags.
I have my 12 kids out for some one-on-one time, and I took
James. They take them out like a pet for one-on-one time?
Vlog with James.
It's that time of week where I take one of my 12 kids out for some one-on-one time, and I took James to this cute little vintage arcade.
That's a crazy sentence. It's the time of the week where I take one of my 12 kids out for some one-on-one time. What? Kid a week? So kids only get one-on-one time like 5 times a fucking year? Are you serious?
Tell you, the nostalgia was awesome. I taught him how to play some pinball.
This is purely a tax write-off. She's gonna invoice this. Okay, now pretend like we're having fun.
Cuber, and I totally beat him in Pac-Man. We had so much fun.
How do you teach pinball? There's two buttons.
After that, we went over to Bill Gray's, where I introduced him to Loganberry.
Imagine, like, you've been waiting, like, months for your enrichment time, and they give you some Loganberry.
We sat down and had some burgers together.
Thank you for spending time with me. James, I believe in you.
Okay.
Oh my god! No way. That shit. No way. No way. It's like a parody, man.
To Loganberry.
This is literally a parody.
And we sat down and had some burgers.
Look, that is not a Someone came on that.
Together.
Thank you for spending time with me. James, I believe in you.
Okay.
Money.
Thank you for spending. That's what I'm gonna do. Whenever I, like, go see Max and I leave, I'm gonna go. Thank you for spending time with me. Max, I believe in you.
Weekly grocery shopping for my family of 14. We needed toiletries for our upcoming trip to New York City. I found these dog advent calendars. And I got Christmas...
You have dogs? Oh, sorry, my bad, no. My bad. Oh, that's cute.
Here's what my 12 kids ate today. For breakfast, I made cheesy scrambled eggs with hash brown patty.
I don't know, I've eating scrambled eggs out of a metal bowl, actually. It's my fucking feet are going, man.
For breakfast, I made cheesy scrambled eggs with hash brown patties, bacon, and peaches.
What are the peaches doing there? Who invited my man? What the fuck are the peaches doing there?
For lunch, I packed them a sandwich, carrots, chips, apple, gogurt, and juice box.
I'm so happy to have you in my life. I think, like, the mum, like, says all these statements, like, in case, like, they ever get pulled up in court for, like, child neglect. Like, no, look at these napkins. Look at this video of me saying I believe in him. Okay, look, man. I love my kids.
I made them an after-school snackerty board to share.
A what? You got them a what? What's that? A snackerty board?
Yogurt and juice box. I made them an after-school snackerty board to share.
This is a really weird combination. I don't like how the pepperoni and the kiwi and the touching. What's the gummy worms on? Is that cheese? You know they all dart for the sweets in the middle and leave the rest. Guys, just soil. This is crazy. Imagine like you're like 2 minutes late to the snackety board and all that's left is like two bits of kiwi and a single piece of pepperoni.
I don't know why they silence.
He's reading her mind through the electric energy.
How I do.
I don't think that does
Here's
anything.
Here's what my 12 kids ate today on Thanksgiving. For breakfast, we got donuts.
He's trying so hard not to shapeshift right now.
Bagels, fancy cream cheeses, and bacon. We had a snack table with nuts, dried fruit, veggies, chips and dip, chips and salsa, popcorn, shrimp, and a cheese spread.
I don't like this. I really don't like the look of that. And I fucking love... Ugh! What's that? I think it's like chicken, but it's like, did it collapse? I got one with no bone marrow. They put it in the oven and the whole thing just fell in on itself.
We had 4 deep-fried turkeys.
That's nice.
Plus all our Thanksgiving favorites. Stuffing, corn and zucchini casserole, corn, gravy, Nana's...
Gravy? You late... You dirty bitch. You dirty bitch. What is this? That's not... Fuck off.
Parents be like, I put a roof over your head, clothes on your back, food on your table. Ain't that what you supposed to do?
Get her out. Get her out. I'm here for Dick Sean.
I'm your child. You had me. I ain't asked to be here. I'm yours.
That dude, this is checking him out. He was like sucking, he's getting the jawline. He was sucking his cheeks a little bit. He was, look at that. This dude, like, he got bored of the video halfway through. Look at him. Watch him the whole time. He goes, I'll check the hair. Look to the side. Get the jawline then.
Over your head, clothes on your back, food on your table. Ain't that what you supposed to do?
And then he looks back, smokes us.
You had me. I ain't asked to be here.
Sucks his cheeks.
I'm yours. Ooh.
He did the Zoolander. He did the Zoolander.
Cardian. I was home with my kid, Mommy Young. Real bitch, I don't be with all that drama. Nah. Money.
Whoa. that was a really quick cut. I don't like this. I don't like this one bit.
Why would I choose between this one or that one when I know that I can have both? Why would I choose between this?
Come Black Friday shopping with us. For our 12 kids, first stop, we went to Costco. We had to get this 12-foot Christmas tree for them.
No, you didn't. You didn't have to do anything.
Then we impulse bought this arcade game. A new mattress for James and some bath bombs for Zoe. Next, we went to AT&T, where we got 12 iPhone 14s, new phone cases, and charger blocks. I also did some online shopping for Deshaun's F7 helmet he wanted, plus Ghost pre-workout.
What the fuck? $500 for a helmet?
For Alex, Pokemon cards for Zoe, Rainbow Friends stuff for Bodhi, and figurines for Jason. Happy Black Friday!
Doherty doesn't thankful roll call.
Alex, what are you thankful for?
Friends and family.
James, what are you thankful for?
Friends and family is my...
And Newports. And Marlboro Reds.
Dogs.
Nevaeh, what are you thankful for?
Roof over my head.
Aww.
Patrick, what are you thankful for?
Friends and family.
Deshaun, what are you thankful for?
Friends and family.
Let him cook.
Wait, what are you thankful for?
Family.
Zoe, what are you thankful
for? I've got any friends.
Thankful for?
My parents.
Dash, what are you thankful for?
Mario.
That's his leader's name.
Jordan, what are you thankful for?
Friends and family.
Jason, what are you thankful for?
Friends and family.
Stomp our answer.
Here's what my 12 kids ate today. For breakfast, I made breakfast pizza with berries.
Breakfast pizza? That is a tray of scrambled eggs with some bacon on top.
Pizza with berries. For lunch, I made PB&J sandwiches with mac and cheese and grapes. We got smoothies.
Chad, do you think they just like put their hand in and just grab handfuls of grapes?
We got smoothies for snack.
Hi, Hoovy.
And for dinner, we grilled steak.
Fuck
with
off.
Rice. And mushrooms.
Fuck off.
And cheesy broccoli.
What?
Bon appetit.
You did not, you big bitch. You did not need 2 plates of cheesy broccoli. Alright, this is all for Alex. I'm not VIP. Why are you not VIP? What the hell? Chad, do you guys want to see what Hoover got me for my fucking present for Christmas? Hoover, can I show them what I got you? We got each other presents, but we didn't even confer beforehand about what they're about. Chad, do you want to see what I got to Hoover? He hung it on his tree, by the way. hung that shit up. All right, at least I put mine out of frame. I have a little shrine. For one photo? No, I didn't know that shit's still up. I know Nick keeps taking it down and you keep sneaking into his room and putting it back up.
Here's what my 12 kids ate today. For breakfast, I made apple muffins with bacon and banana.
That looks disgusting.
Bananas. For lunch, I packed them a sandwich applesauce.
This video...
Weekly grocery shopping for my family of 14. What we got? And two dogs. Snack packs, baking supplies, and stuff to make Rolo Bites. Cookies, Cheez-Its, and cosmic brownies. Juice, olives, applesauce, and canned goods.
How many olives do they eat in a week? That's six packs of large olives.
Olives, applesauce, and canned goods.
I love processed food. This
girl is on fire. Monday mini vlog.
Guys, it was Alex. The people decide which kid. Check, guys, the people decide which kid gets one day enrichment time. Because they did James next.
With Alex. It's that time of week where I take one of my 12 kids for some one-on-one time, and Alex picked Ice Smash. They also have like axe rage throwing room here, which we had never tried before, so we did that first. It's harder than it looks.
Well, it looks quite hard.
Alex hit every bullseye. After that, we went into one of the
ice... Well, he didn't, because two of those he missed.
...mushrooms to break some things.
Yeah, they never actually pick Dash for enrichment time, because he's still building his rocket.
If you've never done this, this is seriously the best form of therapy around.
No, maybe opening up about your feelings is the best form of therapy.
Not to mention, it's a pretty good workout, too. Then Alex drove home.
Because if you ever have some deep-rooted childhood trauma, fill a bottle up with some colorful sand and hit it.
Thank you for spending time with me.
You're welcome.
Alex, I believe in you.
Thank you.
that picture! That's like out of a... It's like out of a fucking Netflix documentary. It's literally like a... That's crazy. It's like a fucking like true crime. The Doherty Killers. Also, this was really zesty. Listen to how he says it.
Alex, I believe in you. Spending time with me.
You're welcome.
Alex.
You're welcome.
Shop for Thanksgiving with me for my family of 14. I even follow rewards. I got 4 14-pound turkeys plus oil to deep fry them in. Tons of snacky snacks and sparkling juice. Got it.
I'm going to start talking like that. This is going to be you in 10 years? Banks, don't you ever say that. What do you think they did before TikTok?
Ooh, a fresh pie.
I got 5 pieces of candy. I got a chocolate bar.
I got a quarter.
I got a rock.
Aww. What's he doing? What's that move? Bodhi's not allowed. It's not time. Jake, you see him? He's jiggle peeking. Bodhi, it's not time for. It's not Bodhi's enrichment day yet. He has to sit in his room. they have like dog cages in them. Bodhi got one sock on. This guy's weird, man.
Opening Sunny D mystery gifts.
That looks real. This looks like I love Undertime Slapper. That doesn't look real.
With my 12 kids.
Sunny, what do you want inside? Imagine it's like a car.
Sunny D is reopening their swag shop for the holidays with hoodies, hats, t-shirts, and more. And you can even purchase an exclusive mystery gift. What a fun present for your family or friends. Happy holidays from the
What'd they get?
Doherty Dozen and
Sunny D!
Opening Sunny D mystery.
I wanna see the Sunny D swag shop. Where is it? Venmo, PayPal, but you are not getting donations from me.
They say...
Check DMs. This is... Colin sent me this as a dash when he goes back to his room.
May I enter, General? I am sorry to disturb you, General. I am sorry. Brokatana wata, hula sepa kumba. Once we worship.
That is Dash when he doesn't have his snackety board and he gets really angry and starts creating energy beams.
They say only females can do this.
Dude, I was just about to start twerking. It's like, damn. Here we go. I don't even think you did it right. Because you moved her feet, like, to that. Here we go. It's tricky to rock around, that's right, on time, it's tricky. It's tricky, 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 tricky. It's tricky to rock around, that's right. His first mistake was trying to do it with socks on. You need that grip. That's my secret. The secret's the grip? Really?
Here's what my 10 kids ate today on Thanksgiving.
Give it a rest. What did Johnny say once? Johnny said give it a grip. he didn't know the difference between give it a rest and get a grip. Bless him. Bless that poor soul. What did average update just DM me and said, can you give us free clout on stream right now? We need followers. Everyone, what the hell is this? Not funny. That's not been approved by me. That hasn't been approved by me.
Slide in, I slide up. Yo, hello.
What's the last one?
Slide up. Yo,
they did that one. Great Wolf Lodge? Where's that?
Here's
what is the Great Wolf
Christmas
Lodge?
Christmas unboxing with Bodhi and the
Christmas unboxing? This was posted on the 11th of November. 16th
and Heroes
November.
Of Gujitsu Goo Shifters.
The what?
Christmas unboxing with Bodhi and the Heroes of Gujitsu Goo Shifters.
Anyone here like the Heroes of Gujitsu Goo Shifters? Guys, they let Bodhi out of his room! They let him out! Yippee!
The Heroes of Gujitsu Goo Shifters are a gooey way for kids to play with no mess. Squeeze, squish, and stretch. Do you have the power to shift the goo, crush their core to activate their goo formation, and release their inner power? Primal Power characters Thrash and Rockjaw have returned to their primal forms of shark and crocodile with chomping jaw action. And the Stretch and Strike Thrash Mobile is...
Fuck off.
Here's what my 12 kids ate today. For breakfast, we had German pancakes with sausage.
What's that?
Sausage links and blueberries. For lunch, I packed them a hot dog, carrots, baby bell cheese, chips,
that's
yolk.
That's gonna be cold.
We're in a snack pack. We grabbed something from the snack bar at the gym. And for dinner, we had tacos in a...
And for dinner? We were sure we did our budgeting wrong, so they all just had a pack of Doritos.
Bag.
Oh.
Which is where you take all of your taco goodness, put it in the chip bag, crunch and shake it, and eat it.
What?
And ice cream for dessert. Bon appetit. Here. Monday.
Isn't that literally what they do with, like, ramen in prison? Like, they, like, throw it on the floor and shit?
Here's what my 12 kids ate today. For breakfast, I made sausage, egg, and cheese biscuit sandwiches with strawberries. For lunch, I packed them a sandwich, celery, Pringles, yogurt, applesauce, and juice box.
Double to you, whoa, whoa.
I made them an after-school snackerty board to share.
Is that pickle? Oh!
weekly grocery shopping for my family of 14, cleaning supplies, paper plates. Can you guess what country?
You guys, paper plates, Four Loko, Mike's Hot Lemonade, and a bottle of Smirnoff.
We're doing for Around the World night. Cereals and snacks, baking supplies, and look at this adorable pancake mold. Pickles for National Pickle Day. Veggies. Feeding my family of 14 spaghetti bread bowls. I got 14 loaves of bread, cooked up some spaghetti, and made up some sauce. I cut a hole into each loaf of bread and brushed it with olive oil.
Nice song,
add the spaghetti, add the sauce, and top with cheeses. Times 14. Put those in the oven at 350 for 5 to 10 minutes. This was so good, I highly recommend.
No, thank you. No, I'm okay, thank you, actually. I actually don't want to put that anywhere near my mouth. And I'm incredibly uncomfortable at the thought of that. Personally.
I took a couple, you know,
Here's what my 12 kids ate today. For breakfast, we had leftovers from the night before, pancakes, eggs, bacon, and peaches.
What were the leftovers?
Breakfast, we had leftovers from the night before, pancakes, eggs, bacon, and peaches.
Stop inviting peaches. They always add, like, the fruits never get touched. Oh my god, Oh my god. Hire a maid. Hire a set of maids. Start selling that shit on Vinted, dude. Get Debop.
I remember when I lost my mind.
That's not them actually talking, is it? Surely they're using someone else's audio. Wait, that's actually them?
I remember when I lost my mind.
Okay, Latspread, Alex. I can see you. You got wings, little bro. Now do a glute spread.
Hi, everyone.
That was crazy. I don't know where that came from.
Here's what my 12 kids ate today. For breakfast, we made pumpkin chocolate chip bread with sausage links and bananas. For lunch, I made grilled cheese sandwiches with tomato soup, applesauce, and goldfish. They grabbed something from the pantry for snack.
Dash is gonna have the Campbell soup.
Something from the pantry for snack. And we ordered Chinese food for dinner.
Oh my god, I bet the workers damn near killed themselves when they saw this order come in. Hi, Pashu. Sorry, I
Bon appetit. Left.
I know some people, they would die for me. We run together, they're my
favorite. This dude's actually a model. Look at him, man. They tried to sneak her in.
Get up, they gon' be high with me. I'll say forever, my.
Why did they make her do that pose? Everyone else got to lean on something. They made her, like, just, like, stand there awkwardly. Oh my god, is that Dash? What the fuck? No, that's not Dash, is it? Oh my god.
Relax. This one.
Yeah. Shawty got that body, yada, yada, hit it one.
Doherty Dozen Christmas Wish List Roll Call.
Alex, what do you want for Christmas?
Ghost pre-workout.
Like most normal ghost pre-workout taker.
James, what do you want for Christmas?
Gaming computer.
Nevaeh, what do you want for Christmas?
Pack of new boards.
Christmas. Keyboard.
Patrick, what do you want for Christmas?
Oh, Nevaeh's easy to shop for. This dude wants a giant arcade Walking Dead game.
Christmas. Giant arcade Walking Dead game.
Deshaun, what do you want for Christmas?
F7.
Bree, what do you want for Christmas? Zoe, what do you want for Christmas?
Pokemon cards.
Dash, what do you want for Christmas?
Bendy and the Ink Machine on the Nintendo Switch.
Jordan.
He knows.
What do you want for Christmas?
iPhone 14.
Jason, what do you want for Christmas?
WWE toys.
Bodie, what do you want for Christmas?
Rainbow Friends toys.
Charlie, what do you want for Christmas?
Donut.
A tiny butterfly.
Too bad, bitch. You're getting an iPhone 14 and an iPad. Take it or leave it. And no one really cares.
Here's what my Monday mini vlog with Bodie. On Mondays, I take one of my 12 kids.
Why does she openly say it? Guys, Bodie got it. Bodie got it beforehand.
Monday mini vlog with Bodie. On Mondays, I take one of my 12 kids for some one-on-one time, and Bodie chose to come to McDonald's, where he ordered a Happy Meal and an M&M McFlurry. We did some good people watching and enjoyed our food and played with the toy. Bodie really wanted to go to Toy Story Land, but we only had a few hours, so we couldn't take a trip to Disney, but he settled for going to the playground instead. I tried my best to keep up with him.
You're almost there.
Yes.
Do you think she's gonna record herself saying, "I believe in you" at the end?
Not have been Disney World, but I still think Bodie had a pretty fun time at the park. Thank you for spending time with me, Bodie. I believe in you.
See the boy. See the boy. In a
moment. Here's what my 12 kids.
Actually, no, hi everyone. The dad like wakes up and like fucking like jacks off in his room all day. Like I'll be so real. Chat. Ending voice. No, I haven't done the ending voice in 6 months. All right. All right, chat. I'm back. Oh, look at that. Look at this bracelet I got. It's crystals. It's for the hoes, I'll be so real. Yeah, I don't believe in it. Chat. I am glad. Did everyone have fun today? Chat, did everyone have fun today? It's nice to be black. Oh, black! Oh my god! Holy fuck! Whoa! Oh my god, dude! Jesus fucking god! Oh my god! Oh! Whoa! Oh, don't! Whoa! Holy shit! It's nice to be back. I don't even know how I slipped up at that one. Last year in the year, it was going so well. That's the worst possible way to end this. Chad, if you're watching the stream.